I'm Grant.
And I'm Nivea, and today we will be discussing racial, religious, and cultural sensitivity.
Reading news headlines about shootings in synagogues and bombings in churches and all sorts of other targeted, hateful acts of violence against minorities,
Grant and I felt it was important to speak with teens and get their opinions on how we can best promote inclusivity and respect for all groups in our society.
Having an understanding of other races and other cultures to a degree where you don't feel uncomfortable talking about it, or it doesn't feel racist or offensive to even say something. Like, just having an understanding of what isn't okay.
You need to be culturally prepared to engage the global space they're going to inherit. Are you ready when you leave Perry High to engage people like you? Maybe somebody who's African American, who is Latina, who is gay or lesbian, who is Mormon, who is Christian, who is Muslim. Our kids must be able to see people's humanity, kids each other's humanity, and be a voice for others in the world. Be a voice for social justice, be a voice to empower another human being, be a voice for a world that promotes and affirms all.
We need people to know that there's still people behind what culture, race, or religion that they are. You shouldn't hate them just because they're part of that culture. You should just see them as a human being. I'd say something like, even at a high school level, implementing education, more education on like different cultures, like having an understanding of how the world works the way it does and how diversity works the way it does. So I'd say implementing classes like that into a broader perspective rather than just having it be an elective class would be a good step forward.
Everyone treating each other like we're all equals, like we're all humans, and we all deserve the same rights and wants and needs.
To have empathy, to have compassion. So they make a gay joke to say, hey, stop it. Somebody make a comment about, oh, we're gonna keep them out of the military to say, hey, stop it. I want my kids to use their voices for all people in the world, right?
The first step to finding solutions is recognizing that there's a problem.
Although you may not personally face discrimination or ostracism for your gender,
your race,
your sexuality,
your religion,
your socioeconomic status, some people do.
We challenge you to expand your social circles.
Talk to people that aren't exactly like you.
And if you're curious why someone thinks so strongly about a certain topic or considers certain words offensive, ask them.
Open-minded discussion is key to establishing racial, religious, and cultural sensitivity.
So regardless of where you come from,
we can all live golden.